This is James Holder for Rifle TV in association with Matt and Jim Arbell. With me, I've got WBO world champion Liam Smith. We're at the press conference today for his second defence against Predrag Radosevic. How are you feeling, Lee?
Good, mate, you?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. I mean, there's been sort of names back and forth, who was the first defence going to be, second defence was going to be, rather. We've all been waiting, so how pleased are you that you've got Radosevic?
Honestly, James, I know, you know, social media, mate, but, you know, I know people are going to, you know, give a stick, but they don't look into it properly. I'm very happy with that fight. Mm-hmm. It was a good voluntary. I picked him last time. I wanted to fight him, you know, before the Jimmy Kelly fight was made. He's a, you know, a good solid fighter, and, you know, kind of like a Arthur Abraham, you know, that type style, solid, and, you know, one of them looks a nasty fucker. You wouldn't want to bump into in the street, you know, one of them. Mm-hmm. And you know, I know he comes to fight, and, you know, he's not like going to be awkward, and, you know, people will enjoy this fight watching it. And he's only lost to Felix there at middleweight, who was a very good middleweight at the time. So you know, I'm happy with it. Like I said, I could go and do it in two rounds. I could have a 12-round war with him, but it's a tougher fight than me last. It's a tougher defence than my last one.
Mm. Just going to ask you this, how does he compare to the likes of Jimmy Kelly? Do you think this is a clear step up in opposition?
Definitely, yeah. You know, you only got to look at, you know, the people he's boxed, and, you know, you look at, what his fights, it's a tougher fight, and, you know, I'm in for a tough night, and I'll have to be switched on, I'll have to be fit, and I'll have to be on my game, and to do a good job.
I know you're fully focused on this, but does your head get turned by some of the names that were mentioned via sort of the social media, if you like,
or
you've got to
concentrate on? Yeah, definitely, yeah. But, you know, I just touch back on that. I'm from too good a family, I'm from too good a gym to be complacent and look past them. I'll talk, yeah, because, you know, once I'm in the gym, I'm only concentrating on one person. But, you know, we're sitting at a table here. I know people say they don't like to look past people, but, you know, I'd be a liar if I'd say, no, I don't think about them type things. I do want the Kelbrick fight. I do want the, you know, the big names and the Cotto fights, the, you know, seeing Amir Khan, now, which is kind of mad because I've just helped him spar, you know, helped him in camping.
He was out,
you know, training
in
his gym. Yeah, it's, you know, it's kind of a mad situation how people are saying me and him fight at 154. But boxing, you never know what can happen down the line. If it's good money for both, then, you know, you can put your little differences beside for 36 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Just get a reaction to what you made of Amir Khan against Sol Canelo Alvarez at the weekend. And if Amir was to fight, you would technically be only dropping one weight, and it was only a pound over.
Yeah, well, that's what people were getting mixed up a little bit. You know, let's have it right. Canelo's only a 154, but he struggles to make it. So that's why he's having 155 fights. He's never a 160. People were saying Amir's jumping two weights. He's not, he's jumping one weight and a pound. You know what I mean? So. And like I say, from Amir's point of view, it's going to be hard to go back to 147 because I've seen him, he's in good shape, he's put muscle on. So it'll be hard for him to go back to 147. So it's interesting to see the decisions he makes. Touching on his performance, I thought he started very well, come out very sharp, left hook, right hand, peach of a shot. But, you know, just like I say, if he'd have hit a 147 with that shot, he'd probably knocked him out that early in the fight. But, you know, Canelo just kind of soaked it up, kept coming, and went through the gears a little bit, and, you know, was, that shot would have knocked middleweights out, 154s out, never mind. People were talking about Khan being a 147, that would have knocked many people out. It was the shot that, a little bit similar to the shot that knocked James Kirkland out. He's a, you know, a big 154, so, you know, he's got no disgrace getting knocked out off that shot. He's just one of them things that happens, and, you know, I was gutted to see him in that state, to be honest with you, because, you know, he's a top lad.
Did you draw inspiration from Anthony Corlett at the weekend? Such a big performance from him. Does that sort of spur you on, if you like, to want to look for the big fights and these unifications?
Exactly, because, you know, I know the way people are on these social media. Is not many people I spoke to picked him for that fight. Not many. And you know, I'd say 20% out of the hundred I spoke to fancied him. And you know, along the lines of, you know, I've seen me and Bruce mentioned, I've seen loads of people like that fight. I've had a few people give me stick over that fight, but that's just social media for you. You know, I was going to accept the Canelo fight. I got absolute slaughter for the Jimmy Kelly fight. And then I was going to accept it. When it come out, I got off of Canelo. I got slaughter for that as well. So, you know, where's the in-between? You can't win So that's why really I don't take no notice of it. I just know what it is. It is what it is with them. I'm mad. But you know, it was great to see him perform the way he performed. Soaked everything up. You know, pushed them back. No one thought he was going to come out and fight like that. And he just one of them. He doesn't get the credit he deserves. You know, he's Mr. Nice Guy, little good looking fucker, isn't he? But he's a tough little bastard, and he doesn't get the credit for that.
There was obviously a lot of talk about Austin Trout potentially for this. He's now facing Charlo. We saw that announced. It was touched on a little bit in the press conference. Yeah. How do you see that fight playing out? And do you think Charlo potential opponent down the road?
You know, when I looked at
either of the
it in the long run, yeah, they're the fights I'd love. You know, I think Charlo beat Jackson for the WBC, his brother's IBF champion. So I love either the Charlo fights because, like I touched on the press conference, they're just good orthodox fighters. Wouldn't make a bad fight with either of them. And now they've both got titles, so they're the fights I'd love. But you know, the Trout one, he got made me mandatory on the same day he accepted the Charlo fight. Don't knock him going the Charlo route. I wouldn't have knocked him if he scrapped that one and come my route. You know, the both world titles, he may be getting more money for the Charlo fight than he would mine. There's a bit of needle between them two, with them being, both being Americans. I've seen them on social media having a go at each other. But you know, as long as I keep winning, I'm going to get massive fights. Anyone wants a unification fight in the 154s has got to come to me. The other three world champions are all trained by the same trainer. Ronnie Shields has got the three. Lara and the two Charlo brothers. They are not going to fight each other. So if you want an IBF, WBO, WBC, WBO, WBA, WBO, then I've got to be involved in it. If there's a unification fight at super welterweight, then I've got to be involved in it, otherwise there isn't going to be one. So basically, if someone wants a Ring Magazine belt, then I've got to be involved in that fight.
Listen, I wish you the best of luck on June the 4th. I know you can't overlook anyone, but hopefully you come through this and get them sort of marquee names that you're hunting out, you know what I mean?
Thanks, James.
Thanks for giving IFL a bit of time today, Liam. I'll catch you real soon.
Cheers, mate.